me. I need to tell you something really important, so can you
excuse me, nurse? Do you think you could put your personal life on hold for a second and do your job?
Can you call me back as soon as you get this? Thanks. What do you need, Maxie?
I'm on my way to Robin's room. I stopped by to see if there were any cards or messages for her.
You got it right the first time. I am a nurse, not a secretary.
Well, I wouldn't brag. How many patients had to wait for food or medication while you begged for Jason's attention?
You know, I've been making a real effort to get along with you for Robin's sake since she's in the hospital and all, but I will not put up with insults or disrespect from a person who got my husband hooked on drugs, faked a pregnancy, and ruined my marriage. I mean, no, really, think about it. What the hell's Finale doing hanging around you? I think somebody ought to warn him.
I need to be very clear. No matter what that jealous cow Elizabeth Weber says, I'm not gonna use, betray, or destroy you.
Well, I already used you, but I apologize for that, and I'm still really, really sorry.
God, I hate that witch, and the feeling is mutual. I can't believe she had the nerve to throw that lucky stuff in my face yet again, and then she insinuated she was gonna cut between us.
I'm sorry, between who?
Us. You and me.
How does the maternal one plan on accomplishing such an impossible feat?
By warning you to stay away from me. By telling you what a black hole I am.
But I already know that. No, what I mean is that I'm well aware of Maximista's past transgressions, but I'm also well aware that you've metamorphosed since then and that you regret certain actions, but I esteem you just the way you are. Past transgressions acknowledged but discounted.
I think I knew you were going to say that, but I kind of just needed to hear it. All right, so come on, Elizabeth, do your worst. It won't be good enough.
Oh.
Sure, I even want to know. Someone who can't normally string more than four words together, you must have mad game. You can't beat these women off with a stick.
Now would be a good time for you to go.
Oh, I don't get to stick around and hear why you and Sam went swimming with your clothes on?
Allow me to escort Fair Maximista safely out the door.
You're just gonna let Jason kick me out of your apartment? That's right, Spinelli lives here too, and I know it's shocking, but he's allowed to have visitors, just like you.
Jekyll cannot divulge certain privileged information, but please just take me at my word. Stone Cold and Fair Samantha are working on a matter of uber importance, so please, your discretion is vital and will be deeply appreciated.
Okay.
Really?
Yeah, well, I can tell it means a lot to you, and you hardly ever ask me for anything. The least I can do is take your word when you say you really need something. Besides, Jason wants to participate in bizarre water sports with his ex-girlfriend. That's not really any of my business. Epiphany, have you seen Spinelli?
It's not my week to keep him.
Oh, this is awful.
Did Mr. Spinelli hurt himself again?
I'm sure he's fine, as long as he didn't drop dead of embarrassment. Spinelli's really sensitive and easily embarrassed. You think Jason would know that and make a little effort to be considerate towards Spinelli's sensibilities, but no, he just waltzes right into the penthouse, dragging his ex-girlfriend behind him. They're completely soaking wet. I mean, if you can imagine, the mind reels. Naturally, Spinelli thought Jason and Sam were history, so you can imagine his complete shock.
Why are you telling me all of this?
You're wise, and I'm worried. I was hoping maybe you could help me.
I don't think anybody can.
That's okay.